Hey everyone, I'm Mike, and today we're going to discuss Brotli compression. Brotli is a Google-developed solution that provides a number of benefits over GZIP compression. In this video, we're going to look into Brotli compression and show you how to check whether your site uses it. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's talk about data compression. In its most basic form, data compression takes the code for a website or app and minimizes the file size. This gives you lighter files to move around the web and reduces the time it takes to load and render a website. You'll find there are lots of ways to compress the data depending on the file type you're working with. You'll find that other file types have ways to compress data. For example, images often take lots of compression to reduce in size without much degradation of the image itself. GZIP compression is a standard way to minimize the size of bundles of files. Think packages such as zip or linux.tar bundles. But up until now, there were no real alternatives. We'll talk more about why an alternative should exist later, but first, let's introduce you to GZIP's competitor. Both Brotli and GZIP use the deflate method to compress and decompress data. This can confuse many people because this alone doesn't warrant a switchover. However, Google is building on top of deflate to offer enhanced techniques and compress data to a greater, faster standard. One technical aspect of data compression formats is the way Brotli compression uses existing known language and text within data dictionaries to employ its algorithm. Developers will use a dictionary of key value pairs to store data as it's efficient, flexible, and scalable. Here's what a PHP dictionary, called an array, would look like. While GZIP doesn't use dictionaries, Brotli uses two. The first is a static dictionary of common code terms that act as a reference for the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript text. There are over 13,000 words in 6 different languages, and Brotli will use these as references to points in the code. This is not an exact analogy, but it's similar to the way a WordPress hook references a larger suite of code. As such, the encoder doesn't have to sift through the code byte by byte. Instead, it can act on the references, pull the definition from the dictionary, and move on to the next one. You'll also find that there are real-world phrases within the dictionary as well as code that wouldn't often see compression. This helps some tags such as HTML and parameters such as type, text, JavaScript take some compression and give you some greater gains. The dynamic dictionary parses content and code at the source, which is good for smaller devices, but not so good for larger files. It's also called a sliding window and can be up to 16 megabytes in size. This is where the compression algorithm caches some of the most recent data in order to reference it. It's ultra dynamic in that it constantly changes. If you compare this to GZIP's sliding window of around 32 kilobytes, you'll see that the scope for real-time parsing and compression is huge. In fact, most typical practices use a Brotli sliding window of around 4 megabytes, which is still mammoth compared to competing algorithms. When it comes to pure user numbers, GZIP compression is still number one. However, Brotli compression sees more use every day. This is in part due to wider adoption measures by the major browsers. The rise of Chromium-based browsers helps too. The Can I Use website records what technologies browsers adopt and provides a history of sorts. This site notes that over 95% of browsers use Brotli compression currently, including all major versions. Brotli is more flexible than GZIP as it has a better compression ratio across every level of compression. And while GZIP does beat Brotli on speed most of the time, the level you compress at factors into the results you'll see. Brotli needs more CPU power to provide a greater factor of file compression. This shows at both the highest and lowest compression levels. Cloudflare's benchmarking backs this up. Much smaller files with closer comparative compression speed numbers. Also, consider that some testing tools such as Pingdom and some CDNs don't support Brotli just yet. This can skew the data others collect on how Brotli operates. You can see false negatives if you do run tests. Higher page speed figures that ignore the file compression you employ. It's worth noting that Cloudflare uses Brotli compression on all of its servers. In fact, it uses a modified and optimized version of Brotli to give you further gains with regard to speed and file delivery. Because Kinsta offers Cloudflare integration on all plans, every hosted site uses Brotli by default. This is just one reason why Kinsta is one of the market leading and best hosting providers around. Because Brotli compression isn't standard yet, you'll likely want to know whether your site uses it. There are a few ways to figure this out. The simplest way to check whether your site uses Brotli compression is through an online tool. While there are a few to choose from, you'll want something that's quick and simple to use that will also give you a bunch of information about your setup. Gift of Speed is our choice to check for Brotli compression. It will determine whether your site uses GZIP, Brotli, or no compression at all, and provide a few other metrics to help you decide what to do next. These metrics offer important insight because you don't only want to consider whether your site's server uses the right flavor of compression. All Kinsta sites use the Cloudflare-powered Kinsta CDN. As such, every site will also use Brotli compression throughout the entire chain and server architecture. Most developers will know that a browser offers some fantastic tools to help you with all sorts of web-related investigation and troubleshooting. One quick check you can make is whether your site or specific asset uses Brotli compression. For all major browsers such as Brave, Edge, Firefox, or Chrome, you can head to the network and then all screen. At first, you won't see anything relating to content headers. You'll need to select an asset or request from the left-hand side. If you keep looking and scrolling down the list, you'll see a panel open up that defaults to the header information. Here, scroll down the output until you see this. Do you have any questions about Brotli compression? Feel free to ask away in the comment section below. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. And thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.